Okay, hello. It's been a while since I reacted to Portishead, and today it's Sour Times. And yeah, I mean, I don't know what happened. I looked through my popular videos basically, and I saw that my reactions to Portishead had like a lot of views, like 500 or something like that. So anyway, I was just like, I forgot all about this band, and I really liked what I heard. And so yeah, I really wanted to get back into them. I haven't heard anything since, like even in my private life or whatever. So anyway, we're gonna do Sour Times. I just picked this myself. No one gave me suggestions or anything like that. So anyway, I saw that this was off of their album Dummy, and I really like that album. So we're gonna see what it's all about. And about my Canadian accent coming through. And anyway, let's just get into it and see what it's all about. And let's go. Oh yeah.
All right,
Yeah, that was a good song. Right off the bat, I gotta say, I really like the music. Just, I mean, the whole beat, whatever. And yeah, I'm noticing, and especially here on genius.com, as it says in the bio here. So it says, I'll just start with that, I guess. Sour Chimes is a song by English trip-hop group Portishead, released as their second single in August 1994. Written by all three members of the band, Sour Chimes features on Portishead's debut album, Dummy, from 1994. So yeah, the trip-hop group thing, yeah, I obviously there's some hip-hop influence in this, and I just, as somebody who likes hip-hop, I like that inclusion kind of thing, whatever that influence. And just that continuous backdrop there, and a backbeat in the background, whatever. And yeah, I really like that. It kept me interested in the song. And I just like how, I guess, I want to say Beth, if I go down, Beth Gibbons. So yeah, she did vocals. So yeah, I like her voice, how it just comes through so softly. And I mean, there's no like screaming, there's nothing like that. It's just very soft and, really nice to the ears, and I like it. Yeah, I just really like the song. I like the other songs I've heard, and I'm finding out here that Dummy was a very good album from the 90s, another great album from the 90s. So yeah, anyway, continuing on the bio. So it says the original 1994 release initially reached only number 57 in the UK, but after su the success of Glory Box in 1995, which I'm pretty sure I listened to that song. It was re-released and peaked at number 13 on the UK singles chart in April. It also is the band's only song to date to appear in the Billboard Hot 100 at number 53. Well, look at that. So then, that's pretty much it on that. And then, there's a little, it says, what are the artists set up the song? So it says, Barrow, he said, Andy Smith, who was an old maid from Portishead, is a brilliant DJ and such a lovely, lovely man. He had a brilliant record collection and had some soundtracks. I borrowed a lot from him, and I would borrow records off him all the time to sample. And that tune was just, you know, it was a straight up hip hop loop. So obviously talking about that loop in the song, which is kind of simple, I guess you could say, but it's very distinct. It's very good. I don't know. It's very nice on the ears. It's just gets in your head, and it's I just really like it. I mean, there's not much else I can say about that. But anyway, looking at the annotations here on the song, it says with the first verse, so it says the fallacy of mourning rose, and the fallacies of mourning roses is mourning roses is a reference to the bride, a symbol of marriage, also the forbidden fruit as the next line, forbidden fruit, hidden eyes, also the forbidden fruit, the hidden eyes, all the symbols of marriage and why it is sacred. And the despise that she pretends to believe in all of that. She despises the hypocrisy of believing in all of these things. It says these annotations are unreviewed. So, of course, if this is not true, you can tell me in the comments and all that stuff. So, anyway, it says in the second verse, covered by the blind belief that fantasizes a sinf of sinful screens, bear the facts, assume the die, and the vows, no need to lie, enjoy, take a ride, take a shot now. That just reminds me of that song, Hey Man, Nice Shot from Filter. And anyway, just take a ride, take a shot now. But anyway, I don't know if I'll do that song. But anyway, the second verse here, all that cheating is a sin or just fantasies, illusions. So just bear the facts and your vows of marriage. No need to lie to yourself that you believe in that, and just enjoy, take a ride, do things freely. So yeah, basically, freedom, a little bit of a theme here. And then the third verse. Who am I and what and why? Because all I have left is my memories of yesterday. Oh, these sour times. So yeah, some deep stuff going on here. It says, I do not need of anything to tell me who I am. Don't need judgments for all I am or my memories. She is not afraid of what people will say. Kind of saying that marriage tends to mean too much on people's lives. So yeah, somebody says this seems more related to a loss of a loved one or just a loss. Not having anything but the memory of happier days when the times are rough. So, again, these are unreviewed annotations, but I'm just taking them all in stride here. And then with the last annotation here in the first or the fourth verse, after time, the bitter taste of innocence, descent, or race, scattered seeds, buried lives, mysteries of our disguise revolve. Circumstance will decide. I really like how they wrote the song and how, I don't know, just how these lyrics go together kind of thing. I don't know. It's very nice. I like it a lot. So anyway, it says, a criticism to the traditional values of to why people tend to get married, like race, ancestry. She forgets all that and just lets circumstances decide. Nobody knows that she just wants to marry with a person that she likes, regardless of race, sex, or color. So, I mean, this song, I guess that's what it's all about, I guess. And then we have the chorus again, because nobody loves me, it's true, not like you. Nobody loves me, it's true, not like you. So, I mean, yeah, this is a pretty good friggin' song. And like I said, I really like the backdrop, beat, whatever. And just looking at Portishead Dummy here, I've heard Mistrons, now I've heard Sour Times, and I heard Rhodes, and I'm pretty sure I heard Glory Box, but I'll have to make sure of that at some point. And yeah, like I said, this song, I loved Gibbons' her voice, just how soft it is. Loved the like hip-hop beat in the background, and obviously that's kind of like their thing with their trip-hop whole little thing, like I said in the bio. And so yeah, I definitely want to get more into Portishead here and listen to more of their stuff, because this is the kind of music that I like. And yeah, as somebody who likes a lot of bands from the 90s, I'm surprised I never like listened to any of their songs. I don't know why, but that's how it went down. So anyway, I guess that's it. Another song with some deep meaning here. Just nobody loves me like you do. And I mean, if you love somebody so much and they love you so much, I guess you gotta be with them, I guess. I don't know. So anyway, just follow your heart, you know? Just like, I guess, what the Ninja Turtles said. So anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. It's all well appreciated. And I really do appreciate the support and all the comments and all that kind of stuff. And whether good or bad, it's all nice. And it's cool that anyone's watching. So anyway, I'll see you guys later. And yeah, have a good one. Oh yeah.